Hello children, how are you all? Welcome to the online edu class of science. Today we will continue chapter number 6, soil erosion and conservation part 2. Children, before starting today's topic, I want to know, have you ever seen a barren land where there is no crop production? And on the other hand, a land covered with vegetation, the greener one? What do you think? Why there is such a difference in the land pattern between these two? Yes, clearly, it may be due to soil erosion. Now, can you think of the ways by which the barren land can be changed into the greener one? So, let us see and find out it. In this part, we will discuss about the soil conservation and various ways to achieve this. First of all, let us understand what does soil conservation means. The protection of soil from erosion is called soil conservation. We have to preserve and protect it as it takes millions of years to form. Soil conservation can be done in many ways. First is afforestation. It is the most effective method to prevent soil from conservation. How? Because afforestation is defined as planting more and more trees on a barren land, and obviously when you plant more trees, the deep and long roots of the trees hold the soil tightly and do not allow the soil to be eroded by wind or water and prevent erosion. Second is growing cover crops. After a crop is harvested and before next crop is sown, the soil remains bare. This soil can easily be eroded. To prevent the soil from getting blown away, farmers grow cover crops such as grass and creepers. The roots of plants of these cover crops hold the soil particles together and prevent them from being blown away. Trees and bushes are also grown along the boundary of the fields, which act as a shield against strong winds. Now, third is terrace farming. Children, as you can see in the picture, why we are saying it as terrace farming? Because it almost looks like a terrace, isn't it? Here, what do? We just cut these slopes into steps. And what is the reason behind this? By cutting these slopes into steps, we are going to reduce the speed of rainwater. Suppose rainwater is coming down, so it will be obviously in a very fast speed, right? Now, if we cut down these slopes into steps, the speed will get reduced, and if the speed is going to be reduced, the washing away of the topsoil is also going to be slowed down. So, by this way, also soil can be conserved. Next method is making dams and embankments. In the picture, we can see the dams are made here. And we know that dams are really helpful for us for soil conservation. Right, children? And when we talk about embankments, what are the embankments? Embankments are the strong walls of rocks that are made near the banks of the rivers. Why? Because the lands or the farms near those rivers will suffer in case floods come. The running water will enter there easily and destroy them. So, the embankments will protect them and prevent the flood water to enter. So, it is also an effective method to protect topsoil from getting washed away. Right, children? Now, the last method is no-till farming. Children, the process of preparing soil for plowing is known as tilling. The process of tilling is beneficial in mixing fertilizers in the soil, making rows and preparing the surface for sowing, right? But the tilling activity can lead to compaction of soil, loss of organic matter, and the death of soil organisms. Thus, no-till farming is a way to prevent the soil from this harm, and it is done by growing crops without disturbing it through tillage. So, students, these are the ways by which we can conserve the soil. We have to try our best to conserve the soil as it is one of our important natural resources. Here, we come to the end of our chapter. I hope you all understood it. After this, go through the worksheet and complete it in your notebook. Thank you.